that Arizona sky, burning in your eyes, and you look at me, and babe, I wanna catch on fire, it's buried in my soul, my California gold, and you found a light. Lovers in the night, poets trying to write. We don't know how to rhyme, but damn, we try. But all I really know, you're where I wanna go, and the part of me that you. When the sun goes down and the band won't play, I'll always remember us this way. Oh yeah, 'cause I don't wanna be just a memory, baby, yeah. Ooh, 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 ooh. This way.
So the last song we had was from Millie Washburn with Always Remember Us This Way, which was a brilliant cover. I mean, thank you so much, Millie, for contributing that. And coming up now is actually an international act, which we haven't had in ages. And I'm going to speak to Bjorn or Björn about Hoven Droven and what made them play their music and play one of their songs. So tonight with us, we have our first international act that was on the show, which was Hoven Droven. And I managed to get one of the members, Björn Höglund, with us on the show tonight. Welcome.
Hi, thank you. Nice to be here.
How are you going?
Good. Pretty good. I'm in Stockholm at the moment.
Yeah, is it hot over there?
It's really hot. It's about 25 Celsius, almost up to 30 the other day. So yeah, it's still summer.
We are jealous. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to ask you, because for me, when we decided to have an international act, you were my first choice because we grew up in the same hometown and
I've always loved your music. I grew up with your music and just think it's brilliant. But can you tell me a bit more about how you started the band and why you chose this genre of folk punk rock, I guess?
Well, it wasn't really rock or punk when we started in 19. We officially started in 91 when we became the six guys that would make the first album eventually. So we always say that 91 is the beginning, because that's when the key members joined, so to say. But we actually started in 89 with a completely different lineup and instrumentation. So we were more acoustic back then, and just tried things out, I guess. And it was not up until the first album is really a compilation of those first years, back to the early days. And it wasn't up until we were about to record the first album in the beginning of 93, that we found something else, that we found that more raw energy. And eventually I would start to play the drum kit and Bo would experiment more with guitar sounds and stuff. And that's when we more grew into a rock and roll band. You can hear that development on the first album we did in 94.
Mm.
That was released in 94, as you say.
And we have this song in the background, which is the county where we're from. Did you find, because there's a lot of good folk musicians over there, obviously, did you find inspiration from the older stuff that was done over there?
Absolutely. Well, the key to the whole thing is really Kjell Erik, who's the fiddle player. He grew up on that stuff. He dug deep into the tradition of these songs and those players. He knew a lot of those players. He's really an ace when it comes to traditional Swedish folk music. So it all comes from him. But he also grew up on hard rock and rock and roll. So I met these guys because I played with Jens, our saxophone player, in another band. So I come from we played rock and roll together. So he brought me into this. And so we all come from different musical backgrounds. But Kjell-Erik definitely stands, you know, deep into the tradition. So yeah. That all came from him originally.
Awesome. And because I'm a stalker. No, I'm not. But my friend Joan, who is a music producer, you were in his studio the other day. What's going on there?
well, wait, you have to do something when during these times. We can't play live, so we really decided it was time to make another album, because next year is our 30th anniversary. So.
Oh wow! Congratulations.
Well, thank you. It's a bit weird, 30 years. Wow. But so we decided to make a new album. So we've been rehearsing for the last 6 months and just started recording. So we have recorded 11 new songs that we're finishing up during the next couple of weeks, I guess, or maybe next month. So yeah, it's going to be a new album next year.
Right. So obviously at these times, you don't know when there's going to be a release party or when all that's going to happen.
No,
but we're hoping. Away. I'm hoping it will be soon, that's for sure.
Yeah.
And I have another question for you. Like, how did you start drumming? And also, I remember you from high school, and I was speaking to my sister this morning, because we both went to the music high school, punk ground school now.
Yeah.
And we both agree that everyone thought you were the hottest drummer ever. And then I also did some research and papers saying that you're one of the best drummers in Sweden. Is this all true?
Why didn't you tell me? You should have told me. Very sweet. Thank you.
Are you one of the best drummers in Sweden?
No, I wouldn't say that. I wouldn't say that. But I've been playing my whole life. I started playing when I was 3.
Wow. Pots
and pans. I got my first drum kit when I was 5. And it's still really the only thing I've ever... It was very it was very clear to me early that this was it. You know, I really can't do anything else. So I've been playing my whole life. So I guess that counts for something.
Absolutely. And you've been playing with some big acts, I believe.
Well, I do record a lot. I record for a lot of different artists. I just finished up recording a big project for a very big Swedish metal act, actually, an international act. But I can't tell you what that is yet. But I've been
really? Because I think everyone's dying to know. Because on this show, we have a lot of metal fans and we try to include metal as much as we can.
So, really? Well, the thing is, I think this band is up your alley, but I can't tell you what it is yet. It's going to be out this year, so it won't be that long before you know what it is. So.
What a teaser. We might have to interview you again once it's out.
You didn't know me with that last question, so now you got it back. No, but I've been recording a lot with a lot of different artists, and I'm actually in Stockholm right now. We're going to do a live stream tonight with another band that I'm in called Easy Action, with a very pretty famous singer here in Sweden named Tommy Nilsson. So it's a band I've been a fan of since they started. I was a kid when these guys released their albums, but I've always followed them up, and I've been playing with them in different lineups for the last 15 years. So we're also recording new material, and tonight we're going to do a live stream. You can see it over there as well. It's live at 9 p.m. Swedish time.
What okay. That would be 5 in the morning here, I think.
Well, okay. I guess it'll be up and running for a few days as well. So if you want to
see it would be. We'll put a link in the comments of the show so people can go and watch it.
It's us.
And I just have to add, this is ridiculous. Tommy Nilsson. When I was, I think my mom and dad keeps telling me the story that when I was probably 5 or 6, whenever he came on TV, I would hide behind the lounge because I was so embarrassed because I had a major crush on him.
Really?
Yeah. Don't tell him that. Or tell him that. I don't know.
I will for sure. I'll send you the link. It's up. And it's Candlemass and two other bands, a really cool band called Thunder Mother and another band called Scarlet. So it's 4 bands. It's a 4-hour long live stream. So I think you'll like it.
Yeah. Lovely. Thank you so much. Thank you, Björn, for joining us tonight. And we'll see you shortly and say hello to all the other guys too.
And Tommy, I will.
Oh, no.